him right now, Victor.
Surprised you're not up there hanging out with him. It's like an ice lounge up there. Hudson, though, getting back to the action, running over Nathan Frazier.
No. Can I make a point here? I mean, you go back to level up when this man, Duke Hudson, went out there and dominated Akira Tozawa. We had Andre Chase on the outside looking at him. My question, what was he thinking? What was he thinking watching his man go out there and dominate and win in grand fashion? What was he thinking?
It's hard to imagine for Hudson focused squarely on business with everything going on with Thea Hale. We saw her earlier now, of course, running with a different crowd, specifically JC.
Let me tell you something. Thea Hale's growing up. She's not like a little kid anymore. She's a grown woman, I think.
Well, Duke Hudson showing his power. Just ricocheting Nathan Frazier off the mat into the cover for Hudson to get two more points and a kick out. Hale was not present ringside this past Friday, not tonight. What is beautiful? What are you talking about?
It's beautiful. Did you see it? Did you feel it?
I wonder, is Noam Dar taking this serious? He thinks this is a party every
single week. Come on, man. Noam Dar, he's a man. He's a man of studies as a whole. He knows exactly what he's doing. The Heritage Cup means everything. When I say everything, I mean everything to that young man, Ben.
Also means everything to Nathan Frazier, who's risking to wipe out Hudson, the former Heritage champion. Pressure down 2 points just to Hudson. Tonight, a loss, he could be virtually out of the Heritage Cup Invitational. His back is against the wall right now, and now his back is on the mat.
Oh, beautiful. I like everything about this kid, Nathan Frazier, but let me tell you something. He's got the heart of a lion. He's got the talent as well, but the competition is just stiff, Vic, here in NXT.
Well, after No Mercy, Saturday, September 30th, Hudson may need a bigger trophy case with how he is rolling throughout this tournament. Now Hudson just got a little more angry, and now we're seeing a side of Duke Hudson we typically don't see.
Now let me tell you something, if Duke Hudson just let that line loose, can you imagine that? Can you imagine what this young man can do?
Well, for Duke Hudson, he's got to black out the Chase U issues and think, how can he distance himself from
Brookby's
side? Looking for that Razor's edge.
He's going for it, Dick.
Frazier trying to counter, and he does. Oh, no. Face first goes Hudson into the top turnbuckle. And Frazier, who's been reeling a little bit, just caught Hudson in the stomach in the midsection. The win. Knock out of Duke. Frazier looking for the Phoenix Splash. Got all of it. Frazier starts to dig himself out of the rut.
Nathan Frazier!
What a bounce back win for Nathan Frazier here in Group B. That was must win for Nathan Frazier as we take an updated look at the standings. Joe Coffey also picking up 2 points. Level up this Friday. Coffey faces Tozawa immediately following SmackDown WWE on Peacock. And while we focus on other tournament action later tonight, let's go back to the Diamond Dojo.